Thank you very much, everyone. My name is David Nahodyl from Gearbox Solutions. I'm the CTO of Gearbox. We're a consulting company in Atlanta. We work with lots of businesses to help make great web apps, and we love using Vue. It's great. A little bit about me. I'm Canadian. See, I didn't want to tell you that before getting up here. But I moved to Atlanta when I was pretty young, and I've been living there since then. Didn't come back here to New Orleans to go to Tulane. Had a great time here. New Orleans is a fun, fun city. But if you asked my wife, and since she helped put the slide together, yep, she put this one in here. She would tell you that I really live here and here. if you're not a big video game player, these are banners from Zelda and World of Warcraft. So, all right. So today we're going to be talking about Nuxt static site generation. This is something we've started to use recently. It's a really powerful tool of Nuxt that works a little differently than your regular Nuxt app. It's great. There are a couple pitfalls you need to look out for if you want to start using this strategy for your development. So to start out, static site generation means that your site gets built one time. When you run the Nuxt generate command, Nuxt goes through and it goes through all the routes of your site and goes through all those links, and it outputs a single HTML package, a folder of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And these are HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files like you used to write when you first started learning HTML, just standalone, nothing special to them. You get this static site as your output that you can then take and upload anywhere. The content all gets read at build time. So anything that you have in your database or CMS, it gets read, gets cut off, and then you don't need that database anymore. So it's a really exciting way of putting your content together. When you do have it like this, it's such a simple thing. It's just a set of files. You can deploy it pretty much anywhere. You can deploy it on the most basic shared hosting. You can deploy it on an S3 bucket. You can do it on Cloudflare pages, or a Raspberry Pi that you're running in your basement if you want. It's really, really tiny. There is no app server. It's just HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files. It's great because it makes it really easy to distribute on a CDN as well. This concept is called Jamstack. Jamstack isn't a particular set of software. It's not a particular platform. It's just this architectural concept of decoupling your front-end web experience from your database, your business logic, and just separating that. Run your build once, separate it, and then just don't need that database anymore. It's an interesting strategy. Your site doesn't have to be 100% static when you're doing this, so don't be too afraid saying, oh, there's some interactive content that needs some forms. You can generate a lot of your site with this Jamstack strategy and display your content and then just send little bits of data back to a server if you need to for form submissions or user logins, things like that. If you are looking for more information on the Jamstack concept, go to jamstack.org. Nuxt is actually listed on there as a site builder. And you compare that with lots of different CMSs. So what are some of the benefits of using Jamstack? Well, first of all, it is super, super fast. I mean, Nuxt is fast already. We love Nuxt. But when you go Jamstack and you're building your whole site at build time and deploying these static HTML, CSS, and JavaScript files, there is no app server. No app server is going to be faster. There is no app server, which is going to be faster than no app server. It is extremely high scaling because these are just static files. You're not going to use up too much memory on your server because you're processing all of these requests. It's very secure. You make this cut when you do your build that disconnects your front-end web experience from your CMS or data source. And so it just reduces the likelihood that you're going to have some sort of vulnerability in your site that's going to end up funneling data back into your database or into some other network, because it's essentially cut off from all of those servers. It's extremely inexpensive because, again, it's just basic files. You can literally just host it in S3. You don't need a real server for this, or on a Raspberry Pi, and you cannot get cheaper hosting than a Jamstack site. And finally, because it's these static files, it makes it really easy to distribute on a CDN. Cloudflare pages, I haven't used it before, but Azure static sites, all of these are the same kind of concept where you upload your static site, your Jamstack site, they distribute it on the CDN, and it gets served very close to your users so that your content loads very quickly. Jamstack.org for more information if you want more resources for these concepts of Jamstack sites. All right, so Nuxt makes generating a static site super easy. It is fantastic for this, but there are a couple pitfalls. You still have to take some things into consideration when building your Jamstack site, your statically generated site, to make sure that you've got an SEO or SEO and that everything's working the way you want it to work. All right, so I'm going to show you a demo now. All right, on here. So this is what you would get if you built a regular Vite view app. I took our website or Gearbox site, I kind of stripped some things out of it and built it a couple different ways to kind of contrast some of these things. So this is if you had a regular Vite site. It looks great. I can click around on the pages here. Things work fine. The pages are loading up. This is all good. I'm happy with this. Except if a crawler comes through here, this is the Vite app. I'm going to turn off JavaScript on here and see what this site looks like without JavaScript. That's not great. No one is going to enjoy this. Our crawlers are going to see this content and just go, oh, I guess there's nothing here. And that's the end of that. And your SEO is ruined. So let's throw this out. We don't want to do that. We want to use Nuxt. Nuxt helps us a lot with this. Nuxt by default is server-side rendered. So that when a bot or a user who is JavaScript disabled, a crawler comes onto your site, they see this. I'm going to turn off JavaScript again on this one. Looks exactly the same. This is fantastic. This is what we want to go for here. This is looking really good. I can click around on these pages. Everything's working well. If I do have JavaScript enabled, Nuxt treats this site as an SPA, which is really great. If I turn this back on, it's going to work in SPA mode. If I turn JavaScript back off, it's regular HTML navigation again through these things. I'm going to go in here, just turn this back on real quick, and so we go into our article section here. I'm going to be really big so that you can see our article titles here. If I go over to the next page here, this is very standard for how you do some basic pagination, right? I'm going to flip through these, and you can see up here at the top, if I can zoom in on this, we've got our query parameter going to page 2. And we go over to page 3. This is the regular way you would do pagination. And it's working here. This looks good. I've got this deployed. This is a static site. The last one we saw was a static site. This is a static site. This is not actually running on Nuxt. This was generated by Nuxt and we're viewing it now. But if I turn off JavaScript on here again, all of a sudden my content changed. It looked good a second ago. I was clicking around on all those other pages and it looked fine. But here I'm supposed to be seeing page 3, but that's not what we've got. We've got page 1 here again. So what happened? If I turn this back on, go to my other pages. Pages are working again. It's almost good, but we're running into a little bit of an issue here when we turn JavaScript off. And the reason for this is the regular way you would do pagination is with a query parameter like this, most likely. And when you have this on your Nuxt server, it's going to be sending this traffic to the server. The server is going to receive the request and show the page that you're looking for. We don't have a server. There is only one articles page, and the articles page we generated was page 1. That's the only page we can see if we're something crawling our site or if we're a user that has JavaScript turned off. If I click on these other pages, it doesn't do anything. It loads the same content over and over because there's nothing to process the query. When I've got JavaScript turned on, Vue's kicking in, it's actually going and hitting our CMS, which is not what we want in this case, but it looks good, and I might think that it's okay in testing. So instead, what we need to do, I'm gonna close this one out, here's another version of the site. Same thing, I've got JavaScript turned on. I'm actually going to turn JavaScript off just from the beginning here to show you how this is going to work. We would go to the article section on here, looking at articles, page 1. I can click over to page 2. Instead of using a query parameter, we're using a dynamic route in Nuxt to get a specific page and a page number here as its own route rather than a page query parameter. This means that Nuxt sees this as a different page and knows that it needs to generate an additional index.html file and CSS and JavaScript and preload all of this page content. Now I can successfully navigate all of these pages through my site. And a crawler that comes on here is going to be able to see all of this as well. So it's just, it's, you have to think about this a little bit differently when you're doing static site generation. If there's not a page for it, it doesn't really exist in your static site. All right, coming back. Let's paste out here. All right, so a couple quick guidelines for success before we wrap up on here. Any content that you care about needs to have a unique URL. You cannot use query parameters. It has to have its own route. Use Nuxt dynamic routing to make this happen. And you can kind of get your equivalents of paginations and a lot of query parameters that you might be using. Test with JavaScript disabled. You'll see different things using JavaScript enabled versus JavaScript disabled because of the way Vue is going to cover stuff up for you that you might think is working properly, but it's not really for static sites. Make sure that the Nuxt static site generation crawler can find your content. When you run Nuxt and generate, it goes through, it hits all of your routes, it follows all of your URLs and go through all those links. If it's not seeing it during the generate process, it's probably a discoverability problem with your site. You can force it in there, but not if you have to do that, maybe rethink why the crawler can't find it when you're doing your static site generation. And finally, use Nuxt modules. There are a couple of great ones that we think really help with SEO. There's a Nuxt image, which will help resize and reformat all of your images so that they're exactly right for the page that you need. And Nuxt simple sitemap generator, which will generate an XML sitemap during your build process and help you get that deployed. Finally, you might still need a server. Your main content is going to be static. Going to be hosted hopefully on a CDN or something like that, but maybe you need to have some user search results show up, or you have a form submission, or you want to have a login, or some other protected content that does have to be loaded dynamically. You can handle all of that as long as it's not something that you need to make sure you have good SEO for, like something that's behind the login. It's totally acceptable to mix a server in there and use that to send your data back and forth. All right, I think that's about another time too, so thank you very much. I'm David Nero. If you have any questions, please talk to me after this presentation. Thanks.